Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics, everyone. I'm Pratima Singh, and I am here today to talk to you about vulnerability management, but in an automated way. Now, why, you might ask? Well, in the recent years, vulnerabilities have taken the IT community by a storm. Every year, there's a record-breaking number of vulnerabilities that are recorded. And with a number of application development frameworks in play and operating systems, it can be a real struggle to patch systems and applications. But before we dive deeper, let's form a collective understanding of what vulnerabilities really are. Vulnerabilities don't just magically appear. They have existed ever since software has. As with most things, we humans create them. They are in the software we write and in the configurations we build. A large portion of vulnerabilities is recorded in the software that other humans write. And such software includes third-party libraries and operating systems that help us run applications on servers. And a major portion of these vulnerabilities is recorded in operating systems. Now, earlier on in my career, when I was a systems engineer, I was responsible for managing 100-plus servers and deploying applications on those servers. Now, every so often, I would get informed about security updates that I needed to install on those servers. It used to take me hours, if not days, to iterate over the inventory, manually install updates on the servers, build manual reports, and reach out to my leads for approval. And even then, almost always, I would have missed out a few servers. Now, as much as I could, I automated the whole system by building scripts that I would manually run on those servers. But then it took me time to build the reports manually and also testing because it added members of the other team to test and the security teams for the final approval. Now, involving other team members added to the lead time. As I started using AWS, I came across the AWS Systems Manager service. That was a game changer for me. I could manage on-premises servers and Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud or EC2 instances alike by installing a single agent. Once the Amazon SSM agent was installed, servers and EC2 instances, essentially the whole inventory that I managed manually, got discovered automatically as managed nodes. With the inventory sorted, I moved my attention to the Patch Manager. I could ditch all my makeshift scripts and use predefined patch baselines for a range of Linux-based and Windows operating systems, including adding approval rules, a task I used to manage manually. Now, this reduced the time I spent on managing patches on servers to a matter of hours. Now, as I explored this service more and more, I came across the feature to schedule patching runs using the maintenance windows feature. Now, I no longer had to sit looking at installations being done on server by server manually. And the Patch Manager dashboard gave me the compliance report automatically that I used to spend hours building to get my leads approvals. As the development teams started to work with containers, it became an interesting challenge to manage vulnerabilities with container images. Container images can be easily overwritten, which can lead to loss of context with changes along with layered development approach, which can result in vulnerabilities hiding in the layers and only detectable in the container runtime. Interestingly, teams could turn on the tag immutability feature in Amazon Elastic Container Registry, or Amazon ECR, to ensure that a container image cannot be overwritten by another image using the same tag but with different contents. This ensured uniqueness of each image pushed to the repository. Now, the teams could also configure scanning of images either on push or continually. But the security team wanted a single pane of glass view of the security posture of the entire IT environment in their organization. Now, this is where Amazon Inspector and AWS Security Hub came in. Now, ECR forwards all findings to Inspector, which is an automated vulnerability management service. AWS Security Hub natively integrates with AWS services like Patch Manager and Amazon Inspector. It supports cross-account and cross-region aggregation. Once all the findings are consolidated in Security Hub, The security team could build insights, alerts, and even trigger auto-remediation actions using the custom actions feature of Security Hub. Now, with Security Hub, we have been able to tie our vulnerability management solution into a neat bow. Now, in this episode, we saw how we could build a vulnerability management solution in a hybrid environment with servers, Amazon EC2 instances, and container images. We've used services like AWS Systems Manager, Amazon ECR, Amazon Inspector, and AWS Security Hub. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.